Julia, and welcome back to my channel. And for today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys my summer TBR. So these are the books that I want to read in my 2 months of summer vacation that I hope to get to. See if it happens. This is not like a strict TBR. It's just very roughly what I hope to get to. First up here, I have Gunslinger Girl by Lindsay Ellie. All I know is this is a YA Western. I've heard decent things from people who've read it. I actually haven't heard many people's thoughts on it, but the things I have heard have been positive. I love Westerns so much, so I'm so excited for this. At least I don't know much about, but it's fine. So next is Freshwater by, I'm gonna butcher that name, so here it is. I believe this deals with either schizophrenia or dissociative identity disorder. I can't speak. I'm not exactly sure which one, but I know it deals with mental health, and it's a new release of this year. It's an adult book. I'm looking forward to it. Getting into some more like YA, like fluffy reads, I have Three Sides of a Heart, which is like an anthology of stories about love triangles. So I guess I'm gonna read this. The cover is beautiful, but this has, who am I excited for? Julie Murphy. I love Julie Murphy. There's Katie Cattigno, Saba Tahir. Yeah, so should be fun. Next up here, I also have Autobiography by Christina Lauren. So I know this one is about a male-male couple, and it also deals with like religion and then being gay but also being religious, I believe, is kind of what happens. That may not be exactly correct, but again, I don't want to know too much going into it. I've heard really good things about Autobiography, and one of my friends really likes it too, so I'm really excited to read this one. Next up here, I have Listen to Your Heart by Casey West. So I have a few of her books on this list. I have Listen to Your Heart, and I have Love Life in the List. So I know this one's like a podcast romance, and then this one, like, this has something to do with podcast romance, and then this one is like some list art something, I don't know. Casey West is really good for the summer. Super light, quick reads, super fluffy. So yeah, I'm excited for these. Next, I also have an arc here that I want to get to, and that is Broken Things by Lauren Oliver. This one's a thriller, so I'm hoping to like kind of leave it till like August. This comes out in October, so technically I'm in no rush to read it. Hopefully August I'll read it. But the town called them liars, the world called them monsters, but only they can uncover the truth. And I read like the first line of this because I was about to start it. I was like, oh my. The first line is, five years ago when I had turned 13, I killed my best friend. I'm like, well, that's a good starting line. That's interesting. So I'm looking forward to reading this one. I haven't heard anything about it from other people who have arcs, but I did enjoy Before I Fall by Lauren Oliver, so this should be fun. Another arc that I have here is Escaping from Houdini by Carrie Maniscalco. I've been stalling reading this because I want to like make it last, and it's bothering me because like I haven't started it because I'm like, I'm gonna be obsessed with it, like I want to like devote my time to it. Like I'm like stalling because I'm so excited about it, and it's like, come on, you got an arc, you can't just sit around. But this comes out in September. It's the third book in the Stalking Jack the Ripper trilogy by Carrie Maniscalco, which these are like historical thrillers, kind of have some feminist themes to them. They're really interesting. There's a good romance plot in there. There's always some mystery. Our main character is into forensics. It's great time. I'm so excited for this one. Hopefully I'll like light a fire under my ass and make myself start this, because I need to start it and stop like stalling. But I know I'm gonna love it, and I'm like, come on. Next up here, I have a new release, which I'm not including, like I'm not gonna put on this list new releases of July and August, like pictures, but there's gonna be some of those. I don't know, there's a lot of things I want to read. But this is The Loneliest Girl in the Universe by Lauren James. All I know is this one came out a few days ago, but I know it was released in the UK before, and I don't know, I've heard good things about it, and I like Sapphire, so great explanation, good job. I also have a few Kings. I have The Outsider by Stephen King. Want to read this one. I've heard, you guys have told me all the Mr. Mercedes and like Bill Hodges trilogy references. That makes me so excited because that's like my favorite series. I'm so excited for this. Again, I've been stalling. Plus, all of you guys constantly tell me to read it, and I'm super stubborn, so I'm like, no. But like, I have to start it. I know I have to start it. Next up here, I have Gerald's Game, also by Stephen King. I'm hoping to buddy read this with my friend Jessica. And this one is about some girl who gets handcuffed to her bed during sex, and her husband like dies. Like the dude just dies, so she's stuck there. And it's about, I don't know, how she survives, what she's gonna do, just sitting there. I don't know. It sounds super weird, but we'll see. Next, I have some like graphic novels and manga and like poetry and stuff. So for manga, you guys are gonna hate me for the stickers, because I sometimes leave my stickers on. But I have Dream and Sun, and this is by Ichigo Takano. It's the same artist who did Orange. I'm so excited, it's the same story and artist and all that. It's like a little comedy. So feels out of place in her home. Her mother is dead and her father, his stepmom, only seemed to care about her 6 month old baby brother. Decides to skip school and run away to a nearby park. She stumbles upon a mysterious man. Never been in love or had a dream of her own, but to secure her own apartment, she's willing to try. It's supposed to be really cute, so I have volumes 1, volume 2, and volume 3. I'm so excited for these. This should be super fun. Also have Snot Girl volume 2, because Snot Girl volume 1 left on a cliffhanger, and I'm really interested to see where the story goes. Again, art is beautiful. It's about a girl with allergies, and there's some mystery components in here as well. She has a fashion blog. This one I should have had in my other stack, but this is the Little Black Book, a toolkit for working women. So it's exactly what it says, but I think it'd be good for like a readathon or something. So like BookTubeathon. Oh my god, BookTubeathon. Let's not even start with that. Okay, I have 3 poetry collections. So I have Helium, hoping to give this one a read. I have, this is like a new release. I hope my voice doesn't skip by Alicia Cook. She also wrote Stuff I've Been Feeling Lately, the one that's like half blackout, half regular poetry. And then I have my friend Julie's collection, Shoot Down the Wendy Birds. So I have these to read as well. I'm super excited about that. There's obviously so many books I want to read this summer. So like, I'm not trying to put pressure on myself to read a bunch. But at the same time, I'm like, Julie, you should try to read 15 books a month. Like, you should try to read 15 books in July. So I don't think that will happen exactly, but we'll see what happens. Let me know what you guys are looking forward to reading this summer. There are some new releases coming out as well that I'm interested in reading. So yes, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you super soon. Bye.